Today, we'll be concentrating on the first of six reports in JAWS Inspect, called the Full Page Report. This report, like all JAWS Inspect reports, is displayed in your browser of choice, and like all the JAWS Inspect reports, the data can be exported or saved. This training assumes you have installed and opened JAWS Inspect on your client machine. First, you need to open and have focus on whatever web page you wish to test. For demonstration purposes, we will use a fictitious website in a Chrome browser purposely developed with accessibility issues. To invoke the JAWS Inspect report menu, as with all JAWS Inspect reports, hold down the control key and right-click your mouse. From here, choose and click on Full Page Report at the top of the menu. As you will see, JAWS Inspect will crawl through the web page, and the Full Page Report will automatically open once JAWS Inspect is done examining the page. The Full Page Report categorizes and visualizes the JAWS speech output by HTML element, such as links, controls, headings, graphics, and more. The Full Page Report is helpful to speed up accessibility analysis by identifying JAWS speech output and helps with making contextual sense by specific elements of a page. Let's briefly walk through this report's features. First, in the header, you will see the URL chosen for the report, the date and time the report was generated, the browser used, and references to the JAWS and JAWS Inspect versions. You can expand or collapse all the various HTML sections of this report. For purpose of this training video, I'm going to use the links HTML element category to review, but you can largely extrapolate this approach for all the other sections of this report. Select is where you can elect to choose all or a subset of all the data rows that you may want to eventually export. JAWS speech output is the crux of this report by displaying exactly what the JAWS user will experience, including in bold green additional verbosity that augments what the JAWS user hears to add clarity. href is simply the HTML reference. Screenshot is an image of the page component. Code is a link to the associated code snippet, and I'm going to click this to demonstrate. Locate highlights the actual physical location of a page component on the web page. An ID is either the unique HTML element ID, or if none is available, the unique ID that JAWS Inspect provides. This is used to identify any of the rows that you may want to export and or eventually upload into your problem management system for tracking. Now let's look through a few rows to see if we can spot any JAWS output concerns. If we look down the report a bit, one of the first things we see are three duplicate rows referencing the same email link component, which may not make much sense to a JAWS user and should be flagged as an issue to correct. Further down is a Yahoo graphic link, but not labeled very clearly. Again, an accessibility developer may want to clean this up for their JAWS community. Let's select a couple of these in order to export. At the bottom of this page, you can export the rows you selected via the Export Selected button, or you can simply export all the rows in this section by selecting Export. Note the spreadsheet that is generated here at the bottom of the page. Okay, this concludes our video training session on the Full Page Report. TPGI hopes you found this overview of the Full Page Report helpful as you go through your JAWS Inspect journey, and we appreciate you watching. Thank you.